People are mistaken in thinking that only gay people need to come out the closet, when in truth, we all do. We've all forced ourselves into these closets in a small space that forces us to restrict who we truly are. Honest walls are guidelines for what we're allowed to do and what we can't. We make ourselves act within these confines that no human being can truly thrive under. The only thing we can do is play the role that we believe has been assigned to us. And each closet is different because each person is different. See, my closet told me that I had to live in a certain way, do certain things in a certain order, and anything other than that would have been failure. My closet had a few clothes, and anything that was a different style to those clothes would have been unorthodox, would have been something that I was not meant to wear, or just weird. See, in my closet, there were certain things that I wasn't allowed to do. Couldn't pierce my ears, couldn't grow my hair, I couldn't be as vocal as I am today. In my closet, I didn't do what I wanted. I did what was allowed. Before I did anything, the first question I had subconsciously was, what will other people think about this? Failing to recognize that most people in a closet of their own so concerned about what they think they can and can't do. See, sometimes my sister asks me for my opinion about what she wants to do. And I promise you, half of the time, I tell her that I don't care. I know that sounds so harsh, but genuinely, I don't care. As long as she's happy, as long as she's doing what she wants to do, I genuinely don't care. And that's my sister, the closest thing to me genetically. Now imagine a random stranger. We think that people care. Before we do anything, we ask, what will other people think? Instead of asking, do I want to do this? Will I enjoy it? Will I gain something from this? Will I learn from this? And always answering the first question first guarantees a life in the closet. And when you're in this closet, there's this quiet sense of desperation to live a life. But you clearly aren't living yours. So you become so interested in celebrities, these athletes, these public figures, because it seems as if they're living their own lives. It seems as if they're not living in a closet. You become so interested in people that you've never met, in people that don't even know you exist, and quite frankly, don't care you exist. They don't care. But at least through the stupidity, you see that, you know what? Other people are out of their closet, living a life that isn't defined by any bounds. And you begin to wonder what it would be like if you broke free, if you stepped out your closet, if you started living outside of your comfort zone. And I've realized that with enough time, each person comes to this intersection where they can either break out of their closet and grow, or restrict themselves so that they can stay in their closet and never grow. It's sort of like when you begin to do the things that you actually want to do, you walk through the world naked. When you try that new thing, you make that new song, you create that new video, you dress in a certain way that isn't quite normal. People make fun of you and say that you're trying to be too different. You're trying, what you're trying to do isn't going to work. They start hating on you. It hurts. But I realized that I actually used to do the same. When I was 13, Fari started releasing music. And I made fun of him at first. In fact, I even remember saying that his song was a whack on his live video. Imagine, his own live video, I commented, this is whack. But you know what? 8 years later, I still sing some of his songs. See, when you do what you want, you open yourself up to extra criticism, to ridicule. Because you become what people wish they could be. No matter what anyone says, they wish they had the courage to truly do what they wanted to do. So when some people see you doing your thing, they cheer you on and use it as motivation for them to go on and do their thing. But others try to tear you down to their level. And that's all it is, an attempt to level things. Some people elevate to yours, others bring you down to theirs. Coming out of the closet isn't about revealing your sexuality or whatever. It's about embracing your true self and leaving the molds of what you think you have to be behind. The biggest lesson I've learned from this is that a little gayness goes a long way. But I'll talk about that later after my next point. The first thing I realized is that once you truly embrace your quirky side, you become unorthodox You're more likely to be criticized because the things you're doing won't be normal. See, there are things in your character that are very unorthodox, that don't fit the mold for anything, that don't fit the mold for people like you. But that's what makes you stand out. That's why I said a little gayness goes a long way, because let's say you get your ears pierced. See, in many places, that's a taboo for men to do. Like, you should never get your ears pierced. In fact, when I got my ears pierced, I think I got a death stare from my dad every day for like 3 weeks. But once you do it, it adds a bit of spice to you. See, it's okay to be a black man that loves going to the gym, but also loves poetry and spoken word. See, it's amazing to be obsessed with fashion because that's what you like. See, whether people think it's normal for a guy to like the things that you like or normal for a girl to like the things that you like, it doesn't matter. Because I've seen that once you go down the rabbit hole of genuinely diving into the things that you're intrinsically interested in, it will reveal a completely new side of life. See, even this video right now is an attempt that has come from me stepping out the closet. This video idea, sometimes I look at it and I'm like, Tej, what are we trying here? What are we trying here? Even in the build-up of this video, I was like, you know what? Let me have fun. Let me post ambiguous things. Let me post things with no explanation to make people think a certain thing about me. I don't think I did it to the best of my ability, but ish, I tried. My conscience was saying, no, let's not go this far. But genuinely, once you step out, you will develop into a person of depth and complexity, because you will no longer be an NPC. You will be you. And you are meant to be one of one. The problem is, right now, you're probably one of 7 billion.